Welcome to Cloudyn Short How-To Videos. This video will walk you through how to create a cost model in Cost Allocation 360. Cost Allocation 360 is a tool that will allow you to segment your data not only by cost entity or account or subscription, but also by tags. This allows you to do chargeback or showback to the business. To get to the cost model wizard, you go under Cost, Cost Management, Cost Allocation 360. You would click the Add button to create a new cost model. And you could select either all accounts or individual accounts in your subscription. To select individual accounts, select the individual accounts options and select the accounts or subscriptions that you'd like to have. Now you can have multiple accounts from multiple providers inside of your cost model. Once you've selected your accounts, click on the categorization tab. This will take you to the pane of discovered tags from your environment. Select the tags that you would like to utilize for the purposes of cost allocation. For instance, if you'd like to select department name, choose that. Or if you'd like to select something along the lines of name, for us, that's what's relevant for our environment, development, database, production, etc. Choose the tags that you'd like to have. For us, we'd like to use name and environment. Environment tells us if it's production or development or pre-production. Now, we at Cloudyn don't believe that it's good enough to just select your tags. You also need to have rules that define how to handle the resources that are untagged. Either they don't have tags applied properly to them, or they're simply untaggable service types. You can select the service types that you'd like to handle and create rules associated with each one. For instance, if you'd like to take your Azure storage cost and distribute them equally across all of your Azure VMs, you'd create a rule like that. If we want to create another rule that says, take, for instance, all of our network transfer inside of AWS and explicitly allocate it to a particular tag, for instance, we might put all of our network traffic on production, we would create a rule that looked like that. Now, the next tab is relevant only to AWS customers today, and that is how you handle individual reservation purchases. We could discover all of your reservation purchases and add them to rules for distribution inside of both your accounts as well as your tag pairs. So, for instance, if these two C3 extra large virtual machines, a total of 24 RI purchases, belong to your production environment, then you would allocate them that way. This corrects some of the accounting anomalies that happen in AWS's allocation of reservations. When you're done creating your rules, click on the Summary tab and choose to either save as a draft or save and activate. Saving as a draft will allow you to come in and edit this model later. Saving and activating will go ahead and enable this model for processing, and it'll take some time for the Cloudyn database to be updated with your cost model. Once the cost model is completed, and it will reflect that in the cost allocation pane as either draft, processing, or completed. Once it's completed, then you can select that cost model in the cost allocation analysis report.